especially films that have two big men faces like Fardeen and Ritesh, you feel like the women won't be that important. If not for her, I wouldn't be here today. I wouldn't be even an actor. You don't have to pit male against each other. Yeah. Their ego does it for them. And now we live in the same building. I mean, there's nothing that can tear us apart right now. So yes, people did pit us against each other, but it didn't affect us. In my second, I get to work with my childhood crush, Fardeen.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Some of the film actors, they might not even ask them who they are if they're standing right beside, you know. Growing up, I never had like a group of friends that I would hang out with. I knew that I was not a Bahu Beti from inside. It was an act that I was putting up. I don't want to be Gora. Yeah, that's a complete no for me if I have to just stand and look pretty. I can do that on Instagram. It's okay, yaar. Don't take yourself so seriously.
Yeah, chalta hai.
Chalta hai. Itna serious kahan leke jaoge apne aap ko? Jana to sabko. Udhar hi hai.
Hello everyone. Welcome to Shosha. I am Ditash Chaudhary in conversation with Crystal D'Souza.
Hi, how are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm good. Absolutely fantastic.
Great. So, Crystal, your second feature film, Visport, has released recently.
Yes.
What has been the response like from your fans, from your peers?
It has been amazing. If we even see the numbers, not just fans and peers, you see the numbers, it's trending number one amongst all the films that are streaming online. It's number five amongst all the shows and films and everything. So, yes, we are topping and I'm loving it. Honestly, my friends and my peers that you asked, they weren't expecting, such a powerful role as well. Because, you know, when you think of having women in films, mostly, especially films that have two big men faces like Fardeen and Ritesh, you feel like the women won't be that important. But Priya and me both are really important. And every character, not just us, Seema Biswas, Sheba Chadda, everyone is so important in this film. And it's so character driven. I feel like, I'm blessed to be getting these roles back to back. Even in Chehre, I had a very important character that, drove the film towards its climax. And even in this, lucky was really lucky for me.
You know, you've always said Ekta Kapoor is like your mentor. Has she watched it? Has she given any feedback?
The first person I ever called when I got Chehre, like when I signed Chehre, when I got out of the office, the first person I called was not even my mom, was Ekta. Because for me, if not for her, I wouldn't be here today. I wouldn't be even an actor. So she's everything to me. Yes, she's watched the trailer, the teasers. Of course, she's very busy and getting time to watch a whole film is a little difficult maybe. Yeah. But whatever she's seen, she's put up the trailer. She has seen it herself. She's supported me in everything I do, not just this, in everything I do. So yes, I think this weekend, coming weekend, is when she's planning to watch it.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah.
And what about your hype girl, Nia Sharma?
Exactly. Nia is also juggling between so many things. But yes, she also has watched the trailer. She's given me amazing feedback and always so proud of each other. Not just, it's not a one-way street. I love what she does. I'm always in awe of her energy, her spirit and how she does what she does. Only she can do it. So I think it's a mutual admiration since years now.
But it's great to see that, right? I remember in one of the interviews, she had said that there was a time when we were pitted against each other, but we did not let that affect our friendship at all. But don't you think this pitting, actors against each other, it usually happens with women actors? It's never with male actors, if you think of it that way.
You don't have to pit male against each other. Their ego does it for them. That's what I feel.
Okay.
But with us, we were so strong. Like nothing could break us. Nothing can break us. We can have our differences. There have been times where we haven't spoken, not out of a fight, but just out of giving each other our own space. But nothing can draw us apart. We are literally, I think ye kuch pichle janam ka ya usse pehle janam ka bhi ho sakta hai saath. Because this is unreal that, we started around the same time. We did our biggest show together. From then, our lives have been matching, even when it comes to controversies, when it comes to issues. And now we live in the same building. I mean, there's nothing that can tear us apart right now. So yes, people did pit us against each other, but it didn't affect us. we were too strong for that.
That's great. More power to both of you. Crystal, let's go back to the time when Chehre had released. That was your film debut, right?
Yes.
And Amitabh Bachchan in your first film. How many people can actually boast about that? You can. Great. But of course, Imran Hashmi too is a fabulous actor.
Yes.
Do you think the release of Chehre and the feedback that you received for it translated to the kind of work offers that you wanted? Or do you think that was a little slow?
I think, you know, that time was a little slow because it was COVID times. Mm-hmm. And our film was announced once and then the lockdown hit. Then it was announced again and second lockdown hit. And then the third time around, and people were so scared to go to the theatres. And rightfully so, because, you know, getting people together after COVID was very difficult.
Yeah.
But however, it did well on OTT. Mm. And the response, yes, was slow because we were expecting it a year ago. And then, you know, by the time it actually came out, the response was very slow. But, you know, thankfully, I have been getting only calls for films, for OTT, for stuff that I'm more keen on doing. You know, it took a lot to erase the Bahu Beti image and to get to where I am today. So, yes. Also, a debut with Amitabh Bachchan. I mean, who gets to do that? I remember shooting with Imran and him telling me it's the first time he's working with Amitabh Bachchan. So,
yes.
So, I mean, he did it after so many films and I got to do it in my first. So, I'm very happy. And also in my second, I get to work with my childhood crush, Akbardeen.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Did you tell him?
Not during shoot, because that would be a little creepy. So, after he finished filming, yes, I did tell him. Come back, Tishk.
But he's so shy, no?
He's not shy. He's a man of few words.
Yeah.
So, he will not speak just to speak. He will if it's relevant, if it's going to make a difference to you or your life or his life, then he will speak. Mm. Otherwise, unnecessary talk he does not do, and I love it.
Yeah. but did it happen so that you were flooded with offers, or do you think that took some time post Chehre?
I don't think anybody that is not too privileged is flooded with offers. You have to go out, hunt every day to get those offers, and then they don't even materialize most of the time because of other reasons that are away from acting and away from how good you are at your job or not. So, it's not easy. It's really not easy, especially, coming out of television, coming out of a medium that people, I don't know why, don't really look up to, because television actors are amazing. Big shout out to them. Most hardworking. Can perform under pressure no matter what. And just, you know, are so hardworking that no other medium can match up, I feel. You know, they're so up there, but I don't know why it's more difficult to make the plunge from TV to films.
Yeah, absolutely. And you did speak about, you know, the kind of discrimination, let's say, a TV actor really goes through, you know, when they want to do a film. And you said that it had happened to me in the past.
Still happens.
Still happens.
Yeah, yeah. It's been six, seven years I haven't done TV. Still get it.
My God, that's so unfair, right?
I don't know. I'm proud of it. Whenever they say you're a TV actor and it's supposed to be something that they're speaking low of, I feel very proud. It's made me who I am today. It's given me my biggest hits. Tomorrow, if I go to any small town, they will call me Jivika.
Yeah.
They will ask me Manvi ka hai. And some of the film actors, they might not even ask them who they are if they're standing right beside, you know. So I feel TV has a great reach with masses.
Sure.
And yes, even today I get the, you're from TV. So,
really?
You know, it looks difficult.
Oh God.
But I don't mind it. I really don't mind it. I'm like, yeah, I'm from TV. I'm very proud.
Yeah, as you should be, of course. And like you said, I think they're really hardworking because we know the grueling work hours
the
in TV.
The hours,
right?
My God. I don't think any... And, you know, we don't get gaps. We do around 12 scenes a day. I mean, we did around 12, 13 scenes a day because Kalka telecast hai. Yahan pe in films and OTT, you get the pleasure of doing 2-3 scenes a day with your gaps for beautiful lighting and amazing rehearsals of scripts that you've done months prior.
Right.
On a TV set, you get a script here. You are already on the master shot while your script is coming taza.
when you look back now, do you think how did I do that?
Yes, I don't know how I did it. I really don't know how I did it. You know, it seems impossible now when I look back, because obviously there's a huge gap now. Mm. But if you put me back on a set, I think I'll be able to do it. I perform better under pressure.
But you know, when you're continuously, you know, shooting, working, always on set, not being able to take chutties, you know, does that take a toll on your mental health?
That's the main reason why I made the transition, because I wanted to have a life of my own.
Okay.
I wanted to have, you know, growing up, I never had like a group of friends that I would hang out with. All my college friends, school friends would go on these holidays and stuff. And I really couldn't make it. I couldn't make it to family functions. I couldn't make it to anything. So that's the reason why after a while, when I was like, you know what, now I am financially a little stable, I can take the plunge. I can, you know, take a break, find work that requires me for 2-3 months and then gives me a gap.
Yeah.
So that's what I did then eventually, and I did it for my personal life, to have a personal life finally, and I'm enjoying it. Honestly, I'm enjoying even the waiting period, even the rejections, even the approvals. I'm enjoying everything.
But it was a courageous step what you did. Not many have that courage, to be very honest.
Yeah, it was. But you know, thankfully, my parents have always been very supportive, and I knew that, you know, it'll happen. Sometimes you just know it'll happen.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, everyone makes fun of me when I put up 11-11 or a 1-1-1 or all of that. But I believe in it. Like, I know, like, the universe is working for me when I'm wishing for things. Hmm. And trust me or not, manifestation works. So it works. Manifested everything that I have today.
Mm-hmm.
And I keep manifesting more.
But if given a chance, would you want to go back there and do fiction TV?
Depends. If I wouldn't mind it at all. If the character is like today's time, if it's progressive, if it's something that, you know, makes me feel like I could bring something to the table to the character.
Yeah.
I'm not too keen on doing like Maitho or regressive stuff, because I don't relate to it personally.
Yeah.
And then after a point, you can do it for a week or two, and then it just gets to you, and mentally you feel like, what am I doing? Why am I doing this? Am I just working for money, or am I working for passion? And if you want to work for passion, you have to do things that you love. So I want to do something more modern, more forward, more progressive, and different kind of characters.
Yeah, absolutely.
And the problem with TV is it goes on for like a year or two. So you're just playing that one character for so long.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas as an actor, you want to be playing different roles. You want to be like, today I'm negative, tomorrow I'm great, tomorrow I'm positive. You know, you want to do these things. You want to have multiple characters.
Sure.
And you can't do that when you're doing a TV show.
Yeah.
It's like one show and that's your life.
Very true. You know, there was this music video of yours that came up on Lake Bewafa.
Huh.
And I remember when it has released, the whole conversation, of course, you look lovely. The conversation just, oh, we never knew she could be so bold. That was the conversation. And then there was, of course, Fitrat also.
Yeah.
I think it's, you know, that conversation actually came up, please correct me if I'm wrong, is because of this Bahu image that you came with. Was it difficult to shed that image for the longest time? Were you struggling there?
You know, I was just scared about how people will take it.
Okay.
I knew that I was not a Bahu Beti from inside. It was an act that I was putting up for a character. Even in between, whenever people used to come for interviews, or when there was, you know, bites that would happen, I would still be normal me. Like, I wouldn't be Bahu Beti or whatever, all of that. You know, Hanji, Naiji, ye sab to nahi kar rahi thi. So, it was just a little difficult to do it, because I thought ki people will not accept. But did I want to do it? Yes, I wanted to do it. Yeah. I wanted to do bold. I wanted to do gold digger. I wanted to do negative. I wanted to do everything.
Right.
It's just that it's a little scary. Will people accept it or not? But sometimes you got to do what you got to do.
You have to take the leap of
faith. It could be a mistake, but it's your mistake.
Yeah.
So own up and then be like, okay, sorry, I'm back to Bahu Beti. Or not, like
or
I
not,
did.
Or not, absolutely.
Yeah.
You know, coming back to Visfot, I think I read somewhere that you had gained weight, you know, for your character. Now, see, while I understand, I do not know how valid this question is in today's times, but as a character, you have to go all out, right?
Yeah.
And, you know, that is what an actor really seeks. But, you know, the kind of profession that you are in, there's a lot of scrutiny over how you look.
Yeah.
How do you navigate that?
honestly, if you ask me, it wasn't difficult gaining weight at that time because I started shooting Viscote right after lockdown.
Okay.
And there wasn't really much workouts going on other than home videos and all that. And the moment I got the call, it was a very girl next door, very like not modern, but a, you know, a sweet girl who runs a cafe and who's a waitress and stuff like that. So I didn't have to look like my fittest best and all that. And I wanted that. I wanted to look as real as possible, as like I had my arms flabbing around. I'm like, okay, that's cute. That's nice. Let's just do it like this and see how it works. And yes, getting back into shape after that was difficult because even then I wasn't bothered. I was eating cupcakes. I was eating this, that. I was not bothered.
Yeah.
And I'm not somebody who indulges into food unnecessarily.
Hmm.
So that was like my full cheat period of I think around 2 months that I just ate, I chilled, I did whatever, and then I got back to it. So yes, I feel like you're under a lot of scrutiny as an actor. The way you look, the way you carry yourself, the things you say can be blown out of proportion, all of it. It's okay. Don't take yourself so seriously.
Yeah, chalta hai na.
Itna serious kahan leke jaoge apne aap ko? Jana to sabko. Udhar hi hai.
You know, when especially when you're starting out, there are a lot of people around you, right? To give you free advice.
Of course.
You should do this, you should do that. This is how you should dress. This is how you should maybe get things done.
Yeah.
Did you hear a lot of that starting out?
A lot. And you still hear it. That. Yeah.
Like what? Tell me a few things.
Like you see my eyes, they're green, right?
Yeah.
Till the time I didn't do Fitrat, that is 2019.
Right.
I started my career in 2008. 2009,
yeah.
I wore brown lenses every day of my life because they said that I will not look like a positive character if my eyes are green.
God.
So I believe them.
And so you wore brown lenses.
Every day of my life, dark brown lenses. And nobody knew people that knew me knew that I had green eyes. But whenever I would act or whenever I would be on a performance or a stage or wherever, my lenses would be dark brown because people said that I will look negative with these eyes.
Mm.
And I don't know why I believed it. And it's something that I will never believe again because I feel like the honesty that you see in people's eyes is when you can look at their eyes and look into their eyes, not through these
things. My God.
So yeah, like that is something I did for around 10 years almost till Fitrat happened and my director said, nothing doing, throw those lenses out. I love your eyes and I want to see through them.
That's so nice.
Yeah.
My God, this still happens, no? Do you still hear these things? Abhi kam ho gaya hai.
मतलब मैंने बहुत चीजें सुनी है कि यू आर डस्की, यू शुड दूध से नहा लो, तुम्हें वो स्किन बेटर लगे. आई एम लाइक, आई एम एलर्जिक टू मिल्क, उसका क्या. दूध से नहा लो गोरे होने के लिए. आई डोंट वांट टू बी गोरा. आई एम इंडियन, आई एम वेरी वेरी देसी. आई लाइक माई कलर. मैं क्या क्यों गोरा हूँ.
यू नो, इट्स ऑफ कोर्स बीन सो मेनी इयर्स नाउ. At this stage in your career, Crystal, what's that one thing which is a deal breaker for you when it comes to a role?
A deal breaker for me is even if it's the best cast ever and if I have nothing to do, I'm just like a pretty prop there, I would not do it. Mm. I want to have a substantial role, a character, things to do in a film, not just dance around trees and look pretty. I don't want to do that. I want to have strong female-oriented characters. And that's a complete no for me if I have to just stand and look pretty. I can do that on Instagram.
That's correct. Lastly, how do you deal with things being written that are not a part of your professional life? How do you deal with that? That and trolls.
How do I deal with it? I used to be very affected in the beginning, to be honest. Now I don't care.
Yeah.
Now I'm like, likh lo yaar, mera kuch nahi jata. Pehle, because the people around me also would get affected.
Mm.
I think now everyone's used to it. Ki agar aap social media pe ho, agar aap aise platforms pe ho and logo ke paas है एक्सेस टू राइट टू यू, दे विल राइट. बट चुपता तब है जब जिन लोगों को आप जानते हो वो आपके बारे में बोलते हैं. तो आई फील लाइक, एंड इट रीचेज यू, लाइक थिंग्स रीच यू नो मैटर वॉट. तो उनके लिए मैं कुछ कहना चाहूंगी. जिक्र तेरा नहीं, छोड़ो यार, छोड़ो, नहीं बोलूंगी.
ओके.
नहीं, अच्छा, मेरी बुराई जरा सोच कर करना, तुम्हारे अपने वाले भी मेरे चाहने वाले हैं.
अरे वाह, हाउ ब्यूटीफुल.
जी, तो चीजें आप तक पहुंच जाती है, आप उसमें बुरा मान सकते हैं लेकिन यू हैव टू बी अवेयर ऑफ आई थिंक अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल अराउंड मोर देन ट्रोल्स ट्रोल्स यू डोंट नो देयर फेसलेस पीपल दे आर सिटिंग बिहाइंड अ कंप्यूटर बट जो लोग आसपास घूमते हैं सांप जैसे उनके उनके उनसे बच के रहो यस
बिल्कुल ग्रेट ग्रेट मोर पावर टू यू थैंक यू सो मच
थैंक यू हाय दिस इज क्रिस्टल डिसूजा एंड यू आर वॉचिंग मी ऑन न्यूज 18